Someone have asked me the question, can a witch be delivered and can a witch be saved? And the answer is yes. I'm going to show you that a witch, glory to God, a damsel that have the spirit of divination, she was delivered by Paul. And Simon, glory to God, was called the great one. He was delivered, glory to God, by the power of God. So I'm making this video to answer the question, can witches be delivered? Yes, a witch can be delivered if they submit their power to God. If they are slave, anytime you are a witch, you are a slave to Satan. You are a slave to somebody that using you, abusing you, and making money out of you. So if you want to be saved being a witch, I welcome you to Jesus Christ. Because Jesus Christ is the man. He is the God. He's the one that want to save you. So never be, you are a slave to Satanism. You are a slave to magic. You are a slave to illusion. You are a slave to Satan. Anytime you are a witch, you are in bondment of bondage. And Paul say, if the Son have made you free, you are free indeed. Stand fast in the liberty where Christ has made you free. God wants to free you from witchcraft. If you are a witch and you are watching this video, my question, glory to God, your question to me is, can a witch be delivered? Yes, can a witch be delivered? And the first one is called in Acts the 16th chapter. Let's go with the sixth, Acts the 16th chapter, verse number 16. Yeah, that's Acts the 16th chapter, verse number 16. And the Bible say, glory to God, listen what the Bible say. The Bible say, glory to God, and it came to pass as we went to prayer, a certain damsel, a little girl, possessed with a spirit of divination, met her. What is the spirit of divination? You speak in things from the occult. You speak in medium. Hey, glory to God, you are like a false prophet. They prophesy out of their own mind, out of their own conscience. So this damsel was hallelujah, she was had a spirit of divination, met us, which brought her master much gain by soothsaying. What is soothsaying? Soothsaying is crystal ball, is fortune telling. Hey, glory to God. This, the Bible says, verse 17, the same followed Paul and us. Who was the us, Silas? And Christ saying, these men are the servant of the Most High. Yes, I'm a servant of the Most High. I'm a servant of God. I serve God day and night. God is my Savior. God is my source, which show us the way of salvation, how to be saved. Every time I get on a YouTube video, I'm showing people how to be saved. So this damsel was crying out, saying that these are servant of the Most High will show us the way of salvation. And this did she many days. So this damsel was following Paul and Silas, tormenting them, saying that, come see a man. Come see men, the servant of God, that's showing us the way of salvation. And in verse 18 say, what did verse 18 say? And this did she many days, but Paul being grieved, turned and said to the spirit. He spoke to the spirit. He didn't speak to the girl. He spoke to the spirit, and I command thee in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her. So the Bible say that, glory to God, the spirit that was in the damsel came out of the damsel, and the Bible say, and he came out the same hour. Hey, glory to God. So if you are a witch, God can deliver you from witchcraft. Because witchcraft is part of the flesh. Witchcraft in the category of fornication, in the category of homosexuality, because all those things are enslavement. Hallelujah. Those are, glory to God, working of the flesh. Fornication is working on flesh. Committing adultery is working on the flesh. So witchcraft is working of the flesh, and it become a spirit of divination. So Paul, glory to God, hallelujah, rebuked the spirit, and the Bible said, glory to God, and he came out the same hour. Hallelujah. So I'm telling people, my friend, that's why I'm passionate in this thing called salvation, because salvation is the real deal. Hey, glory to God. If you are not a servant of God, I welcome you to come in and be a servant of the Most High, because God is real. That's why I don't understand atheists. Atheists, they are blind and they are ignorant. Because Paul went to Athens and said to a scripture, to the unknown God whom you ignorantly worship. So I'm answering the question for those that say, can a witch be saved? Yes. The spirit of divination from this damsel was delivered. Hallelujah. And Bible say, the reason why I say it's true, because and verse 8, and when her master saw that the hope of their gain was gone, they called Paul and Silas and threw them into the marketplace unto the rulers, and they brought them to the magistrates, saying, these men, being Jews, do exceedingly trouble our city, and teach custom which are now lawful for us to receive, need to observe, being Roman. So what the end of the story is, they put them in a jail. They put them in a prison. But while in prison, glory to God, God delivered them through an earthquake. And God sent blessing, God sent healing to the prison. Because the Bible says in verse 27, and the keeper of the prison, awakened out of sleep and seeing the prison door open, he drew out his sword and would have killed himself, even almost commit suicide, supposing that a prisoner had been fled. But Paul cried. That's why I'm crying every day on YouTube, to tell people to get saved. This thing is passionate. I'm passionate about the work of being a servant of Christ. Hallelujah. It's not about the subscribers. Hey, glory to God. I want to receive the crown of glory one day. Because the money will fade away. But the crown in heaven, when God will say, well done, my good and faithful servant. So the men, they want to kill themselves. But Paul cried with a loud voice saying, do thyself no harm, we are all here. And the Bible say in verse 29, then he called for the light and sprang in and came trembling and fell before Paul and Silas and brought them out and said, sir, what must I do to be saved? Then they cried, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved and thy household. And they spake unto him the word of the Lord and to all that were in the house. And he took them the same hour of the night and washed their stripes and were baptized, he and all his way, straightway. And when they had brought them into the house, he set meat before them and rejoiced, believing in God with all the house. Now I'm telling people, my friend, this thing called salvation is a real deal. Hey, glory to God. Now, first ask me, can a witch be saved? Now, Simon, glory to God, he was a witch. Hey, glory to God. Because the people, listen what the Bible say. Hey, glory to God. The Bible say, when there were certain, that is Acts 8 chapter, verse number 8. Hey, glory to God. 8 chapter, verse number 9. When there was a certain man called Simon, which before time in the city, same city, used sorcery, used magic. He was a witch and bewitched the people of Samaria, giving out that himself was a great one. And the Bible said, to whom they all gave heed, from the least to the greatest, saying, this man is a servant, is great power of God. Hey, glory to God. But the Bible didn't stop right there. The verse say, and to him they had regard, because that of a long time he bewitched with sorceries. Hey, glory to God. But when they believed Philip preaching the thing concerning the kingdom of God and the name of Jesus Christ, they were baptized, both men and women. I'm telling people, a witch can be saved. Hey, glory to God. Verse 13 say, then Simon himself believed also, when he was baptized, he continued with Philip, and wondering, beholding the miracles and the sign which were done. Hey, glory to God. And listen now, Simon got saved. Simon got saved. Hey, glory to God. Verse 15, who, when they were come down, prayed them that they might receive the Holy Ghost. For as yet he was fallen upon none of them, only they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Verse 17. They laid their hands on them and they received the Holy Ghost. And listen what Simeon say. And when Simeon saw that through the laying on of the apostle's hand, the Holy Ghost was given, and he offered them money. So can a witch be saved? Yes, a witch can be saved. Hey, glory to God. And listen what's saying. So he offered them money. He's trying to buy this thing called the Holy Ghost. You can't buy the Holy Ghost. Witch, you cannot buy the Holy Ghost. Verse 19, saying, give also this power, that whosoever I lay hands, he might receive the Holy Ghost. But what Peter say to him? What I'm saying to you that's trying to buy yourself the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is not for sale. Verse 20, but Peter said unto him, thy money perish with thee, because thou thought that the gift of God might be purchased with money. I hope the prosperity preachers are listening to this. Hey, glory to God. Then listen to what he say. Thou hast neither part nor lot in this matter, for thy heart is not right in the sight of God. Repent. He told him, repent, therefore, of thy wickedness, and pray God, if perhaps the thought of thine heart may be forgiven thee. Hey, glory to God. I'm telling people, my friend, a witch can be saved. Yes, a witch can be saved. If you are a witch and you're watching this, a witch can be saved. Simon was healed of his witchcraft, and he offered to buy the Holy Ghost. And also the damsel, hallelujah, was saved. She was cast out the spirit of divination, and they locked up Paul and Silas. So I'm telling people, a witch can be saved. And I hope you are a witch and you can be saved if you want to be saved. Hey, glory to God. Until then, may God bless you richly, is my prayer.